Hello everyone, welcome to Andy Visits. Movies have really annoyed people over the years. There was once a time when they were so unpopular among polite society that the mayor of New York tried to ban movie theaters altogether. Yet, they have persisted, irritating and offending people throughout history. Some films, however, push the envelope a bit too far. And these are the works that end up going down as some of the most contentious artistic endeavors in the history. With this list, we have compiled the worst offenders. These are the films that got banned, the movies that caused protest, boycotts, and public condemnation. Some of them deserve your scorn, while others may have gotten a bit more heat than they deserved. Antichrist. For a film to shock in the 21st century, there must be something pretty special about it. Antichrist managed this at Cannes in 2009. The spiraling depression of the female character known only as her takes a violent toll on him, with graphic depictions of her drilling into his leg, hitting his genitals so hard that he falls into coma, and eventually cutting off her own genitals with a scissor. Critics frequently described this as the worst film ever made, and four people fainted while watching it. One woman even claimed that she has a miscarriage as a result of watching it. I Spit on Your Grave. I Spit on Your Grave is the heart-wrenching, sordid tale of woman's ordeal of gang rape and her dealing with it through vengeful, torturous murders. Apparently inspired by a real-life rape story, this movie boasts the longest rape scenes in cinema at 25 minutes long. There is no doubt that this film is influential, and the 2010 remake only heightens the violence and torture that poor protagonist Jenny must endure. The poster at the time of the 1978 movie release stated no jury in America would ever convict her. That's just not true. Murder is a crime, as rape is, and advertising the eye for an eye approach is a controversial subject matter to consider, not to mention the infamous rape sequence. This makes the list of the length and nature of that rape scene, along with psychotic actions of Jenny after her ordeal that led her to murder. The Human Centipede 2. This movie's infamy has spread and the name has become synonymous with field of film. The first installment of The Human Centipede was bad enough, but director Tom Six slated the sequel was designed to make the first look like My Little Pony compared with part 2. This is a feature-length graphic depiction of coprophagia rape, horrendous torture, and to top it all, of grossly inaccurate medical procedures. The Exorcist. Religious controversies had to make an appearance in here somewhere, and what better example than The Exorcist? The tale of a young girl's possession by a demonic spirit is an intriguing tale and a worthy story to be enthralled by. However, the use of subliminal imagery throughout the film, along with such a young actress in the challenging lead role, led to major controversies regarding its release. Ambulances were stationed outside cinemas for the fainters, and it landed a place on the notorious video nasties list in the late 80s and 90s in Britain. A Clockwork Orange. Set in the future, we follow a gang of misguiding youths in this movie who rape and pillage the local area every evening. Alex, the protagonist, ends up in prison after preventing a gang uprising and is subjected to therapy, a type of Pavlovian classical conditioning, which manifests in psychological torture. He leaves prison with only his body condition to hate violence, even though his mind still desires the ultra-violent acts of rape and murder, leaving us with the thematic question, is it better to choose the bad, retaining our free and violent will, or have the good imposed upon us to be determined by the state? Cannibal Holocaust. Maybe it's the documentary style of this movie that caused such a stir, or maybe it's the savage mutilation of humans and animals. Maybe it's the actual footage of execution, or all of the above. As Cannibal Holocaust is a film that is not for the faint-hearted. The clever integration of documentary style within the piece allows the audience to experience the horror in a strange context of realism, and it makes for interesting viewing. The controversy surrounding this film is huge. When it was released, the director was arrested for murder and the movie was confiscated. If anything, that is testament to the quality of the footage created. The actors who had signed contracts saying they would not appear in the press for over a month after the release of the movie to perpetuate the idea that were really killed, and had to appear in court and enact some of the more bloodthirsty scenes in order to spare Deodato a lengthy jail sentence. A Serbian film. Another entry from Still Manages to Shock, a Serbian film deals unforgivingly and graphically with the relationship between art and taste. The story centers on Milo's, a semi-retired porn star who is offered a role in an art film and accepts to secure his family's financial future. The horrors that await him are beyond his imagination. Not only is child abuse and child pornography used with this movie, but also the horrific idea of newborn porn is depicted, and a scene later in the film shows a 5-year-old boy getting raped by his father. This obviously caused a bit of stir when it was released to say at this list. The interview. From just watching the interview, you would hardly imagine it deserved a place on this list. As a film, it's in the same vein as many other Seth Rogen and James Franco comedies, a willing combination of gross-out humor and male bonding. That said, it does contain a political twist, as real-life North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un is portrayed as a misunderstood Katy Perry-loving soul who bonds with a hack TV journalist who is assigned to interview with him in North Korea along with his producer. The movies and TV shows like Team America and 30 Rock have often mocked Kim Jong-il, Kim Jong-un's father and predecessor. The interview may have touched a nerve with the young despot. In December, a group called the Guardians of Peace hacked Sony Entertainment and threatened to carry out terrorist attacks if the film was released. When major theater chain dropped the film, Sony released it digitally instead, potentially costing themselves millions in box office revenue.